Welcome. Thank you for joining us on this special service of worship. We come together on Christmas Eve from across this province, this country, across the globe, to gather together to celebrate the coming of the Christ child. During this time of worship, we trust God's hand will be upon you and bless you, that you will be drawn near the Christ child, the child in Bethlehem, that our lives will be forever transformed because we encounter him anew today. May you celebrate with us as we share this family service of worship together. May we celebrate the coming of the Christ child. Throughout our service today, a number of our young people from both Canoe Cove and Clyde River churches will be helping out with readings and singing and all sorts of things today. So join with us as we worship the Christ child. We're going to begin our service as we share our call to worship. And our call to worship today will be led by Amelia and Elise McCory.
In the beginning was the Word.
And the Word was with God, and the Word was God.
In him was light.
And the light was the life of all people.
The light shines in the dark.
And the darkness has not overcome it.
We now come together to light our Advent candles. And this day we light the Christ candle. May the light of Christ shine in the darkness. May the light of Christ shine in our lives. May the light of Christ shine through us into the world this day. Let's turn to him now. Let us pray together. Wondrous and loving God, we thank you. For we know that you stir within our hearts and minds a sense of joy, a sense of hope. You remind us that on that very first Christmas, hope was given, peace was shared, joy was seen. As your love was shown in the Christ child. May we experience those gifts this Christmas season. As we draw near to Bethlehem, as we encounter the Christ child, may we experience those gifts anew, and may our heart be forever changed because of the gift you have given to us. Abide with us now, we ask in Jesus' name. Amen. Throughout our service today, some of our young people will be sharing readings, and those readings are taken from a liturgy by Reverend Dr. Sarah Travis. Our first reading is entitled An Introduction. As we draw near and as we begin our journey to Bethlehem. Our introduction is shared with us by Abby and Clara Jack.
On a night long ago, in a place far away, a baby was born on the first Christmas day. His name was Jesus, a tiny wee king, and he came to the world to change everything.
Let's go to Bethlehem and see the baby that came to love you and me. Come to the stable and gather around the manger where baby Jesus is found. Come all you children and hear this story of a tiny baby who would grow into a king of glory.
We're now going to be treated to some special music, a carol that is well known and well loved. And this carol is shared with us by the Bowers family and some of our Clyde River Sunday School children. They'll be sharing Away in a Manger.
Away in a manger, no crib for his bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay. Cattle are lowing, the baby awakes, but little Lord Jesus, no crying he makes. I love thee, Lord Jesus, look down from the sky, and stay by my cradle till morning is nigh. Hear me, Lord Jesus, I ask thee to stay close by me forever, and love me, I pray. Bless all the dear children in thy tender care, and take us to heaven to live with thee there.
Away in a manger is one of those carols that many of us know by heart. It's one of those carols that have a deep meaning for us and point to the birth of the Christ child. It reminds us of God's love for us. It also reminds us of the journey that was taken on that very first Christmas. And our next reading is entitled The Journey to Bethlehem, and it will be shared by Peyton and Hunter Crozier.
Mary and Joseph were tired and sore. They had traveled all day and then some more. Finally, they arrived in Bethlehem town, only to find there was nowhere to lie down. The hotels were all full. There wasn't a bed for Joseph's poor mother to lay down her head. The baby was coming, and it was so late at night. Dirty and ragged, they made quite a sight.
They asked a man if they could sleep in his hay, in the barn with the animals, where the cows lay. The man showed them a spot, it was warm and dry, and Mary and Joseph sat down with a sigh. And they slept for a while the stars shone, and waited for morning, for night to be gone.
Each Christmas season, we all make that journey to Bethlehem. We all make the journey and we all put ourselves in that place. Somewhere in the story we find ourselves. That little town of Bethlehem. Such a small town. An unimportant town. But in that town, we see the coming of the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. We're going to invite you now to sing along with the Christmas carol that we know and love so very well, O Little Town of Bethlehem.
Deep and dreamless, keep the silence dark.
We're now going to take time to reflect on God's word as it is brought forward to us. Our scripture lesson today is taken from Luke's gospel, reading verses from Luke chapter 2, as we share the Christmas story together. And Alexa Aiken will be sharing with us in God's word.
Luke chapter 2, verses 4-14. And Joseph also went up from Galilee, from the town of Nazareth, to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house in lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed, who was with child. And while they were there, the time came for her to give birth. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling cloths and laid him in a manger, because there was no place for them in the inn. And in the same region there were shepherds out in the field, keeping watch over their flock by night. And an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were filled with great fear. And the angel said to them, "Fear not, for behold, I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. For unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a baby wrapped in swaddling cloths and laying in a manger." And suddenly there was an angel, a multitude of heavenly hosts praising God and saying, "Glory to God, the highest, and on the earth peace among those who with whom he is pleased."
The reading from Luke's gospel reminds us of what Christmas is all about. Sometimes we can forget, or it can get lost in the shuffle or pushed to the side. But as Alexa shared with us today, it is about the Christ child. It is about the journey. It is about encountering the wondrous gift God has given to us. It is about the Christ child being born. And so our next reading is entitled "Jesus is Born," and it'll be shared by London and Gray Corbin.
While it was still dark, Mary woke with a start. The baby was coming, she knew in her heart. So it was in the barn on that cold, dark night that Jesus was born and then wrapped up tight.
As he lay in the manger where the animals eat, a sheep came and nuzzled his tiny wee feet. And even the smallest creatures gathered around, while a tiny new baby made small little sounds. A dark, dark night wasn't dark anymore. The light of a star shone through the stable door.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
The birth of the Christ child is one that forever changed the world and continues to change each one of us. A lot of times we focus on Jesus and Mary and Joseph, but there were others involved. The shepherds, keeping watch over their flocks by night. Shepherds who were simply minding their own business when their lives were forever changed. They are part of the Christmas story. They are an important part that cannot be forgotten or shuffled aside. And so now we share a reading entitled The Shepherds, and it'll be shared with us by Emma, Flora, Charlotte, and Callum McLean.
There were shepherds whose job was to care for the sheep, and it was very late, and they were fast asleep.
But they didn't sleep for long that night, because the star and the angels were shining bright.
The shepherds were scared, they weren't quite awake, but the angels said, "It's good news for heaven's sake.
A baby was born, get up, come see. This good news is the best, the very best that can be."
So the shepherds ran off,
and their sheep came too,
and they saw for themselves
that the good news was true.
Tied in with the shepherds is, of course, the angels. The ones who brought those tidings that very first Christmas, who let the shepherds know what was happening, who directed them where to go and how they would find this child. This is in part their story as well. For they were able to announce the coming of the Christ child. They were able to share the joy of his arrival, the excitement of his birth, knowing that because of Christ, the world would never be the same again. We now share their story, the story of the angels. And it'll be shared by Montgomery Stead and Jackson Cameron.
When angels appear, the good news is clear. The beautiful little Savior of the world is here. They shouted out loud that the new babe was found.
In a manger with his family gathered around, the angels say, sang songs which gave God all the glory, because God is the beginning and the end of our story.
Just as the angels praised God that very first Christmas, just as the angels celebrated the birth of the Christ child, we too can now lift our voices in praise as we sing the carol together, Angels from the Realms of Glory. May we sing with a sense of joy and a sense of wonder.
Before the
One of the interesting things, and I don't know whether anyone else watches it, but I like those behind the scenes. Those behind the scenes documentaries that show what goes on behind your favorite television show or the making of your favorite movie or documentary. It gives you an insider's perspective, an insider's look of things you wouldn't have known or expected. Today we're going to share a clip, and I enjoy this clip. It's probably one of my favorite Christmas clips. It's from a church in Auckland, New Zealand, St. Paul's. And it's entitled, The Unexpected Christmas. And as we share this clip, think of it as a behind the scenes look at a story we know so well.
Have you ever wondered what we might see if we could pull back the curtain of time to that very first Christmas? If we could, I imagine the story began in heaven something like this. God was looking over heaven's balcony one day, shaking his head at all the wrong things people were doing down on earth.
Oh man, this isn't quite what I had in mind when I created Earth. I feel so far away from my kids down there.
Why?
It's just hard to be friends with people when you don't like what they're doing. I think it's time.
Time for what, Lord?
Time for us to step in.
Shall we read as a army, Lord? Teach them a lesson?
No, I don't think we should send an army. Maybe just one person.
What person?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, if we're sending just one person, it'll have to be someone very powerful and very strong. Because there's tons of people down there.
No, they don't have to be strong. They'll be going as newborn baby.
A newborn baby?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, this plan is rather risky. A newborn human baby is small and weak. This baby must be born to people who protect him. Maybe a great ruler or mighty king?
Actually, I was thinking I could send him to a young peasant girl whose heart is beautiful and full of courage.
A peasant girl?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
My lord, I see you're planning to take Earth by surprise. No one will be expecting a newborn baby born to a humble villager. But what good can a baby do?
This will not just be any baby. I'm sending in the Prince of Heaven in disguise.
The Prince of Heaven?
Our Prince?
Your son?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, this is too risky. Sending the Prince in disguise as a tiny baby, born not to kings, but to humble villagers. Surely our Prince cannot be born in a cottage. He must be born in a palace.
You're right. He shouldn't be born in a cottage.
Phew.
He'll be born in a stable.
A stable? Surrounded by animals?
Filled with hay?
Filled with poo?
Brilliant! They won't be expecting that!
Lord, how will all the people know he's there? What if they don't notice?
Those who are looking will find him. And his mission will bring all people closer to me, even if they do something really wrong. When the prince is done, nothing will get between them and my love.
Can we leave some clues for the people looking? Like in the stars?
Clues in the stars? Sure, why not? We can make one huge one that points to him.
Can we sing for him?
Yes, can we sing?
Sing to welcome.
Please say we can sing.
God looked at their hopeful faces, and his heart was touched by their love for the prince.
All right, you can sing.
Yay!
But not in front of the whole world. That would just be weird. And no kings or rulers.
How about we sing for some shepherds?
That's a lonely job.
Those blokes could do with some cheering up.
Brilliant. They won't be expecting that.
You know the rest of the story. An angel visited humble girl with a courageous heart and told her the good news. She will have a baby, and he will be the Prince of Heaven, who would help Earth to be close to God again. As planned, the baby was born in a stable about as far from a palace as you can get. A group of wise men noticed some strange clues in the stars. They packed their belongings and followed the star right to a baby. And of course, a bunch of lonely shepherds were guiding their sheep when all of a sudden the sky was lit up by thousands of angels singing. Nobody would ever expect that.
I always smile when I see that clip. I play it at least once or twice during the Christmas season because it reminds me to not take the Christmas story for granted. To remind me that God had a plan. Right from the very beginning. In the beginning God created, in the beginning God had a plan. And his plan included the Christmas story. His plan included sending his son. But unfortunately, the Christmas story, well, sometimes it can get boring. Because we hear it over and over again. We hear it from Matthew's gospel. We hear it from Luke's gospel. There's nothing new. Nothing changes. It becomes part of our Christmas to-do list instead of our Christmas experience list. We bake. We decorate. We buy presents, we bake some more, we wrap our presents, probably bake some more, and then we make our way on Christmas Eve or Christmas Day to church. We sit and we listen to a story we've heard 10, 20, 50, 60 times before. We've come to expect it. We know the twists and turns. It is just part of what we do on Christmas. But when we lose that sense of wonder, when we lose that sense of the unexpected, we miss what God has in store for us, what God has planned for us. We miss such a vital component of that Christmas story because it is about the unexpected. I love in that clip the little fellow who always says they wouldn't be expecting that one. At every twist and turn, those twists and turns that we take for granted are really unexpected twists and turns. And in reality, the world wasn't expecting it. The world wasn't expecting the Son of God to come. He arrived with no fanfare. Except for the angels, of course. But Bethlehem had people. There was no room for them. So they had to stay in a stable or somewhere. So think of it. This little town was filled with people, and no one noticed the birth of the Christ child. No one noticed the coming of Christ. Because it was unexpected. Because they didn't understand what was happening. You see, we see the Christmas story as predictable, as planned out. But as that little clip reminds us, and as we look at Luke's gospel, it reminds us that the Christmas story is anything but planned out. The Christmas story is about twists and turns. It is about the unexpected. It is about Mary giving birth to the Son of God. It is about the Son of God being born in a manger. It is about the Son of God being worshipped and praised and glorified, not by kings or princes or princesses, not by the rich or the powerful, but by shepherds who were scared to death out in the hills because all of a sudden angels appeared to them. They weren't expecting that. But in the unexpected, their lives were forever changed. In the unexpected, Mary's life, Joseph's life, was forever changed. This Christmas season, may we be prepared to expect the unexpected. And in doing so, have our lives forever changed. You see, a lot of times we miss what God has in store for us because we think we have it all figured out. We think that our lives go in this direction and this direction only. But as we see with the Christmas story, as we see with God's own Son, it's about the unexpected. It's about that twist, that turn that will forever shape us and change us and mold us into the person God wants us to be. And it starts this Christmas. It starts this Christmas by asking God to show us the unexpected. Because in the unexpected, we see opportunity. In the unexpected, we see possibility. In the unexpected, we see Christ. Just as the shepherds did that very first Christmas. So don't miss what God has in store for you. Don't miss what God has planned for you. This year has been as unexpected as we could have ever imagined. Last year at this time, as we were preparing for Christmas Eve services, no one could have guessed what would have happened in 2020. It certainly was an unexpected year. But even in the midst of that unexpectedness, we see God moving. We see God changing. We see God challenging. And we see God pushing forward, sharing the hope, the peace, the love, and the joy of His Son. May we experience that gift today. May we rejoice in the gift of the Christ child. And may we give Him thanks for this Christmas season and all the unexpected wonder that we will encounter. We're going to turn now to God. We're going to take time to pray and share this time in His presence. Let us pray. God of hope and healing, God of love and amazing grace, You have revealed Yourself to us in that little town of Bethlehem. You have shown to us the depth of Your love in the person of Your Son, Jesus Christ. You have loved us so much that You sent Your one and only Son. And out of that love, we are forever changed. Out of that love, our hope grows strong. Out of that love, there is a peace which passes all understanding. Out of that love, there is a joy that makes us want to shout and celebrate and praise Your name as the shepherds did so long ago. We thank You for the gift of Your Son. We thank You that He came to earth not as someone of power or strength or might, but He came as a child. We thank You that He wasn't born to kings and queens, but rather to humble folk. We come forever changed because of Christ's birth, realizing that in the Christmas story, You have shown us once and for all how far You would go to bring us back home. In the Christmas story, You have shown us the depth of Your love . In the Christmas story, You give to us a glimpse of the unexpected ministry of Jesus Christ. In the Christmas story, You remind us that no matter who we are, no matter where we come from, no matter our background, You see us as Your sons and daughters. Help us, O God, to bring to bear the light of Your Son into a world that is struggling, into a world that is trying to make sense of the year that has gone by. Help us to shine the light of Christ to those who are struggling with illness and sickness, with those who are struggling with diagnoses. Shine the light of Christ in their lives so that they are reminded that they are not alone. that they are loved by you, and that in the darkness, your light illuminates their path. We are mindful of all those who grieve, all those who mourn, all those who need to be comforted this Christmas season. We think especially of the MacPhail family as they mourn Eric's passing. We give you thanks for his life, for his faithfulness, for his love for you and your kingdom. Watch over his family now. Comfort them and speak to them. The hope found in the Christmas story. The hope found in the Christ child. May that be our hope as well, as we continue to seek you and your kingdom this day. Be with us. We ask in Jesus' name. Amen. We're now going to share our final reading for our service. It's entitled The First Christmas, and it'll be shared with us by Kinley and Carly Duncan.
No one slept on that first Christmas Eve. The child was so special, no one wanted to leave. They sang praise to God for sending such joy in the form of a new and perfect baby boy. The star kept on shining so that the whole world could see that God loves everybody, including you and me. Tonight is a time to say thank you to God for what happened that day. Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the bright sky looked down where he laid, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the hay.
Just before we share our closing carol, we're pleased to have some of the children from the Canoe Cove Sunday School share with us what their favorite thing is about Christmas.
Christmas is spending time with my family and opening the presents with my family.
My favorite thing about Christmas is going to the farm and eating lots of food.
If you don't know what Gracie likes, it's her first Christmas.
I like that we all get together as a family and go to any of our family's different houses to eat our Christmas supper, and I like seeing Santa Claus.
What I like about Christmas is that my family gets together and we usually go to our Nan and Papa's house, but sometimes I like making cookies for Santa Claus, and also I like spending a lot of time with my family.
Hanging out with my family.
Giving Santa cookies, presents, and cars.
My favorite things about Christmas are music, lights, and desserts.
Closing hymn today as we go from here is a carol that speaks of the awesome wonder, quiet reverence, the deep joy of that first Christmas. May we share together in the carol, Silent Night, Holy Night.
Thank you.
In the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen.